In this illustration, we'll discuss about a swinging pendulum, where in the situation we are given that a ball suspended by a string swings in vertical plane at a given angular amplitude such that the acceleration of ball are equal in its extreme and bottom position. And we are required to find the angular amplitude of swinging ball. Here, if we draw the situation in solution, here you can see this is the bottommost position of the bob, and when it swings to an angle theta, then at this point its velocity is zero from where it starts, and when it reaches bottom it attains a speed v. So here we can write at bottom position the speed of ball is, this can be written as root 2 gh, as only gravity is doing work on it. So in this situation, the height to which it has fallen is L1 minus cos theta. So this will be root 2 gl1 minus cos theta, that is the speed at the bottom point. Now at the initial point, when it is at its extreme position, only force on it is mg. And here, due to mg sin theta, it starts moving. So we can write at extreme position, acceleration of ball can be written as, say if this point is A, this point is B, then acceleration of ball at point B we can write as only g sin theta. As its speed is zero, no normal acceleration is here. And at the bottommost point, as the tension is acting in vertical direction, mg is also acting in vertical direction. So no force is acting in tangential direction, so only normal acceleration it will be having. So we can write at bottom position, acceleration of ball can be given as a we can write here as v square by r, that is L. So on substituting, this will give us 2g 1 minus cos theta. And we are given that acceleration of ball at point A and B are equal. So if we equate the two, this gives g sin theta is equals to 2g 1 minus cos theta. And we can open these trigonometric terms in half angle form. So this 2, g gets cancelled out. This 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2 is equals to, this becomes 2 sin square theta by 2. So this 4 sin square theta by 2, where 1, 2 gets cancelled out and sin theta by 2 gets cancelled out. So this will give us 10 theta by 2 is equals to 1 by 2. So the value of angular amplitude we get is 2 tan inverse of 1 by 2. That will be the final result of this problem.